final topic, gestational diabetes mellitus by Dr. S. Chandrasekaran. I now request Dr. Chandrasekaran to come forward.
Actually, I am not prepared anything.
What are you doing, doctor? Is it doctor?
I said, come and sit with him. I won't sit with him.
Doctor, you are doing. It's my personal privilege to work in Devraj Manikchand Maternity Hospital, Jain Hospital, which entirely caters to the pregnant women, healthy pregnant women. And that has prompted me into this subject of gestational diabetes mellitus, because the three basic problems we recognize there is diabetes mellitus, respiratory obstructive airways, and hypothyroidism. These are the three problems a pregnant mother commonly faces. We just go through 10 questions and Lakshmanan will share his opinion. What are the normal blood values for a normal person without any comorbid conditions?
Normally, women, non-pregnant person, women, and all men, if the fasting is 126 milligrams above and postprandial is more than 200 milligrams, they are declared as diabetic patients. And now, hemoglobin A1C is also added to it. If it is more than 6.5%, is a diagnostic of diabetes. In between, there is impact fasting glucose is there, where fasting glucose alone is elevated, but the postprandial is 140. They have probably insulin problem. They have reduction in the insulin, and the glucose output from the liver, which occurs in the night, is more because of decreased function of insulin, so that fasting level increases. But with the food intake, that is carbohydrate intake, it stimulates the pancreas and some insulin has come effectively and postprandial is maintained as normal. Another is the postprandial hyperglycemia, where only the postprandial glucose is very much elevated, but it's not diagnostic of 200, more than 140 to 200, but as fasting level is normal. These are earlier to developing diabetes. And in pregnancy, 2% are there. One is the fetus and the mother. So they share whole metabolism and all the nutrients of the mother. So the level of hemoglobin, the A1C also comes down, and the glucose level also comes down. What are the levels? I will wait for his next question.
The leaders in the making the normalcy in pregnancy are Indians. Indian diabetologists, starting from the M.M. Sahuja on to Sanjay P. Moses, to M.S. Shunathan, others, others, youngsters, younger patients. Now still, the International Diabetic Federation puts as 160 postprandial as normal and 110 as normal for pregnancy, which is not acceptable to the Indian standards. The Indian standards, you must remember, only three values. 90 is the limit we accept for the fasting state. The postprandial after a good meal of glucose should not exceed 140, and 2 hours should not exceed 120. Therefore, the three values and numbers you must remember, you should treat for the purpose, is 90, 140, 120. Now, the definition of diabetes is, good old definition is a vascular cum metabolic disease, of which the metabolic component is more prominent in the pregnant woman than the vascular component. The metabolic component is dictated by the need of the placenta acting as a very equitable then we eat the hormone metabolic homeostasis. Placenta is the one of the best hormone metabolic homeostasis, which tends to protect the fetus and give the fetus a 24 hours continuous supply of oxygen, uninterrupted supply of oxygen, uninterrupted supply of glucose, uninterrupted supply of nutrients. When that is being maintained, the mother has to sacrifice and her level should be 90, 140, 120. Now, if this level is small, what test will you do in a diabetes to prove, in a pregnancy to prove a diabetes?
Small addition to what you said, 90 and all. At present, fasting 80 and postprandial 120, that is not.
Am I here?
That fasting 80 and postprandial 120 in the first trimester of pregnancy, that's more important. Previously we were telling you doing the second trimester and all. No. Even in the first trimester we have to do this glucose test. 80-120, very simple test. And when you look at the A1C, it is 5.4%. Normally up to 6.5%, not pregnant person, 6.5% can be taken normal. Already I told you, the fetus is there, mother is there, so two persons are sharing the metabolism. So the hemoglobin A1C comes to 5.4%. If it is more than that, they have to be subjected for detailed studies for the diabetes genome. And the question you asked is, what test we do? See, to do 2-hour GTT and all, it is very laborious for a pregnant person. You have to ask the person to come fasting and then do all this. Is, you know, the Indian housewives, they are attached with household work, they have to look after their family. We know the way in which that way, if they are a working person, still more difficult for them. Now, for that, Seshaya has contributed a lot in this field. And he has said, glucose challenge test. It can be done at any time, irrespective of food what they have taken. Any time. They can come after breakfast, after lunch, anything. So you give 50 grams of glucose and estimate blood glucose after 1 hour. Is more than 140 milligrams, they should be subjected for study of diabetes medium, that is GTT to be done. And then we go on with the other tests. So it is indication, and if you have facility, we can do the HbA1c. If it is 5.4%, yes, go ahead with the probable diagnosis of GDM.
The point is,
sir, can't this be followed for non-pregnant people also, same thing?
No, sir.
Not pregnant. No, not pregnant. For non-pregnant, it is slightly higher level. Yeah. Non-pregnant person is 1%. A pregnant person are 2%.
No, I'm saying this sort of testing, that is, you said that. Can we follow this for normal other individuals, other people?
No, for the 200 is the cutoff for yes. Normal person.
200. I have worked with Dr. Shalom and he has the very good method of diagnosing diabetes in his preoperative and other patients. When the patient comes, he gives glucose. After 1 hour, he takes the blood sugar in his lab and then he labels them. You are at mark 2 being investigated for diabetes. You are need not be investigated for diabetes. This practice, sir, I think we should appreciate and excellent. There's no doubt about it. You can do it. But to diagnose diabetes, as he said, we have to go for further test. Now, the same thing in the first trimester is applicable to the occult hypothyroidism. But the TSH, thyroid stimulatory hormone hormones, are kept as 0.2 to 2 for the first trimester, whereas kept as 0.3 to 3. 2.5 now will be reduced to 2 or 2.5, whereas in second and third trimester, lenience of 0.5 more. Now, we said we go to treatment, three questions, and close the session. Now, diagnosis.
Sir, even for GDM, OGCT, now the amount of glucose you give is 75 grams. And then after 2 hours, if it is going to be more than 140, it is definitely diagnosed to be here. If it is between 120 to 140, then there comes the problem like impaired glucose. Then we ask them to be on meal plan or medical nutrition therapy and we repeat it afterwards. Okay. If it is more than 140, we treat them like a diabetic.
Yes, madam. 140 is a big, as I said, first trimester 80, 120, second trimester 90, 140, right? Now, how do you start treating? So that you have established 150, 160 diabetes postprandial. How do you start treating?
And lifestyle management, as madam said, what has to be planned? If it is around the 90, 140, if it is more than that, insulin is one of the best drug. But still, some of the doctors treat with metformin. They say it can also be given. But in my practice, I usually use insulin to combat. You have to be very careful when you are treating with insulin. The patient should not go in for hypoglycemia, which can cause fetal hypoglycemia and death. We have to remember the insulin agonist hormones, when we get hypoglycemia, we the other hormones are produced, cortisol, the adrenaline and all, to increase the blood glucose. That mechanism is not there in the fetus. So we should be very careful with treating it. Correcting mechanisms are not there, and we should not bring down to hypoglycemia of the GD. That's only the rest. Now it's very easy. We have the glucometer. Immediately we can self-monitor glucose meter. I still remember when I was in Stanley 40 years here, I was working with Dr. U. Mohammed. The laboratory will close by 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock. They don't receive the sample. Many of the seniors will know. We get the results only next day. So I used to treat with the urine sugar model. Of course, in those days, GDM and all, we were not thought about that. We were born with that.
So when we use a glucometer,
yes,
are you supposed to reduce the level which shows by glucometer, is it the same with your...
Absolutely, it is same. It is same. Now, the improved glucometers are very good and it is in par with the laboratory test. At least in laboratory, we have to keep on standardization. We have to hear nothing. And latest glucometers, which are made in USA, there are so many fake glucometers are there. Some glucometer, that's very good. I'm not advising it. It's a standard.
I will only add a word of caution to both of you. Definitely, the electronic BP apparatus and the electronic measurement of the, that is light measurement of the glucose values are improved. But still, at extreme of temperature, they fail. One of the areas of extreme of temperature is the scooter. Many of the husbands have taken them to the scooter, it becomes hot. Same way, extremes of temperature has to be very careful. When you expose these two instruments to extremes of temperature, the variability will occur.
Especially in the glucometer, not the meter, the strips. The strips should be preserved properly in the fridge. It's kept open, it's an alcohol enzyme. It's kept open for a long time or exposed and it becomes erratic results. And what kindly advise all your patients to have one glucometer and one BP apparatus at home. It has become mandatory now because hypertension is increasing in a lot and many hypertensives are not diagnosed. So it is mandatory to have these two instruments at home. Kindly advise all your patients to have these two. And it is very simple to use these instruments.
Even though majority of the clinicians today are using insulin, still I should state reputed institutions as well as senior are still using oral hypoglycemia including some people in Muslim League called Bellur, some other centers in Australia and New Zealand, they have the association, they are still using the oral drugs and they feel they are satisfied with that. I will not go into the controversy at this point of time.
What is the normal level for established diabetic case? What are the cutoff levels?
That is pre-gestational diabetes, but cutoff level is the same. That is called pre-gestational diabetes, diabetes becoming pregnant. Gestational diabetes mellitus is a pregnant mother becoming diabetic. Pre-gestational diabetes, diabetes is the patient becoming pregnant.
Previously, GDM term was used. A normal person becoming diabetic during pregnancy. Now GDM comprises of one normal person becoming diabetic and a diabetic become pregnant. Both can use and the R6 are same.
Now sir, last question about the insulin analogs which are approved today for the pregnancy which are not approved with that conversation.
Human insulins can be used. But about the lantism or something large, some studies are there they use. But human insulin, Actrapid, Mixtard are not commonly used. And there are no deleterious effects of that.
So as it stands today, preference is for established human insulins,
yeah,
not for the commercial insulin.
Some studies are there.
Some studies are there, people are using it, but now for ordinary day-to-day general practitioner bedside treatment, the conventional insulins. Any other questions from the audience? Please go. Yes, sir, please.
Place of insulin pumps, sir.
I have raised a pertinent question about the glucometer value and the venous pressure. Capillary blood contains a lot of sugar. Therefore, there is a restriction that is 15% difference between if you take the capillary blood.
Sir, I won't agree 15%. If at all, very few milligrams. I don't think 50 milligram is taken away by the tissues from capillaries to the vein. Few milligrams may be there, but still we can take them. And regarding the insulin pump, insulin pump is used when the diabetes is not controlled well, and there are a lot of variations are there, and high glucose level, then we use the insulin pump.
I am happy he is professor of medicine at the Naval Medical College, HOD, who ran the diabetic clinic at Slim Valley. It is southern data. Southern data, what you are giving is a northern data. Sir, they say the manufacturers as well as some of the recent studies, sir, with the recent introduction of modified strips, the difference is less. That's what they claim. Any other question? Thank you very much. We had a question.